नमस्कार, हार्टी वेलकम टू ऑल नॉलेज सीकर्स टू माय चैनल। दिस इज डॉक्टर मधुसूदन राव कड़पा। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द बर्थ एंड डेथ प्रोसेस इन क्यूइंग थियरी कॉन्टेक्स्ट। ए बर्थ मीन्स अराइवल ऑफ ए न्यू कस्टमर इनटू द क्यूइंग सिस्टम। सिमिलरली ए डेथ रेफर्स टू द कंप्लीशन ऑफ सर्विस टू एन एग्जिस्टिंग कस्टमर। So whenever a new customer enters into the queuing system, it is said that a birth has took place, and whenever a customer leaves the queuing system after getting his service completed, a death is said to take place. So here, in order to explain the complete process and to derive the balance equation, now let us have a look at the states here: 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on, n minus 2, n minus 1, n, n plus 1, and n plus 2. These are the different states. That means at any time t, n of t equal to n, which means that the number of customers in the queuing system at time t equal to small letter n. Now, this theory is based on three important assumptions. Now let us take the state n straight up. At time t, let the system be in state n. Now the system is in state n. That means there are exactly n number of customers in the queuing system at time t. Now from here onwards, if we count the time until the next arrival of a customer or service to any one of these customers, I mean completion of service to any one of these customer may take place. Here the inter-arrival time, that means the time interval between arrival of any two successive customers, will follow some probability distribution. It's a random variable. The inter-arrival time is a random variable. It follows some probability distribution. That means the time interval between arrival of any two customers is not a constant, it varies. Similarly, the service rate, that means the service time, as the service time required for customers are different depending on the type of service they get. So it's also a random variable and it follows some probability distribution. Now according to assumption one, suppose n of t equal to n, given that n of t equal to n at time t, then the current probability distribution of the remaining time, the current probability distribution of the remaining time until the next arrival or birth takes place, that means the state changes from n to n plus 1, the current state is n, with the next birth the state changes from n to n plus 1, and this follows exponential distribution with parameter lambda m. So given n of t equal to n, the current probability distribution of the remaining time until the next birth or arrival of a new customer takes place follows exponential distribution with parameter lambda n. Next, assumption 2. Now we don't know when we started clock time t, with the passage of time, we don't know whether a new customer will enter into the queuing system or one of the existing customer may leave the system. Similarly here, as at time t, the number of customers in the queuing system, n of t equal to n, small letter n, then the current probability distribution of the remaining time until the service completion or a death takes place will follow exponential distribution with parameter mu n. That means the state may reach from n to n minus 1 with service completion to one of the existing customers. So Here, the time within which the state changes from n to n plus 1 or n to n minus 1 depends on whether a birth takes place or a death takes place within that time, remaining time. So whichever is shorter, that means for the next customer to arrive, how much time is left here at time t? The next customer may arrive at some time delta t. So after t plus delta t, the next customer may arrive, or otherwise, a customer may leave the system within this time. Now, the remaining time within which an arrival or departure takes place is a random variable, and whichever is shorter, that will take place first. Suppose if the service completion takes place first, then the system will move from state n to n minus 1. If a new arrival takes place, then the system may move from state n to n plus 1. Now, in the same way, we can write for all states here. Suppose the current state is 0, then with a parameter lambda naught, the state may change from 0 to 1. With a parameter lambda 1, the state may change from 1 to 2. Here, these lambda and mu, these two are state dependent. That means the remaining time within which the next arrival or next service completion will take place is state dependent. Similarly, for state 3, it is lambda 3, state 4, and so on. From state n minus 3 to n minus 2 with lambda n minus 2, lambda n minus 3, this is lambda 2, right? Next, from state n minus 2 to n minus 1 with a parameter lambda n minus 2, and from state n minus 1 to state n with a parameter lambda n minus 1 like this, and from state n plus 1 to n plus 2 with a parameter lambda n plus 1. So this is how the parameter changes depending on the state. It is a state dependent system. Similarly, mu, here when state is 1 with a service completion, the number of customers in the system will become 0. Similarly, at state 2, if a service completion takes place before the arrival of a new customer, then the state will reach from 2 to 1. If a new arrival takes place before the service completion, state may move from 2 to 3, or with a service completion, it may move from 2 to 1. With a parameter, this is mu 1, this is mu 2, and this is mu 3 for third to second state. This is mu n minus 2, and this is mu n minus 1, and this is mu n. Here this is mu n plus 1, and this is mu n plus 2. So this is how the parameter changes for different states. Now, the random variable according to which a new arrival or a service completion, that is a birth or death, takes place are independent. A series of random numbers that we take for inter-arrival times and series of random numbers for service times are independent. So, the state may reach from n to n plus 1 with a birth or n to n minus 1 with a single death. So that is the third assumption. So these are the three assumptions based on which the birth and death process has been explained. Now, let us see how to derive the balance equation for any state n. Suppose if we consider a state n, say this is the state n at time t. Now, En of t is the number of times the system enters state n. Now, how the system will enter state n means, when the number of customers is n plus 1 with a service completion, it may enter state n. Or when number of customers is n minus 1 with a new arrival, it may enter stadium. So there are two possibilities to enter the state n. That is, with one service completion from state n plus 1 to n, or with a new arrival from n minus 1 to n. These are the two possibilities. Similarly, let ln of t is the number of times the system leaves the stadium. This is the system, number of times system enters stadium in time t, and the number of time it leaves stadium in time t. Now, if you observe, over a period of time, the system will enter stadium, leave stadium, enter stadium, again leave stadium, again enter stadium, again leave stadium. Because alternately it takes place. Entering and leaving a particular state will take place alternately. So over a period of time, if you observe, the difference between these two, that is the number of times the system entering state n minus number of times system leaving state n, this will be either 0 or 1. Because if it enters as many times as it leaves the state, or after a cutoff time, it may be in that particular state, or may be entering into the other state or leaving that state. So the difference between the number of times the system enters state n and leaves state n is either equal to 0 or 1. So we can write like this: mod en of t minus ln of t less than or equal to 1. Now let us divide this expression throughout t. Then what we get? By t here, by t. And let us take the limit of this function where t tends to infinite. That means if we observe over an infinite period of time, then what happens? Naturally, 1 by t, when t tends to infinite, 1 by t tends to 0. So the limit of this function, en of t by t minus ln of t by t equal to 0. So we can divide this, or we can split this into two terms separately, and we can write like limit of en of t by t when t tends to infinite is equal to limit of ln of t by t when t tends to infinite. This is the mean rate at which the system enters the state n, mean rate in, and this is equal to the mean rate at which the system leaves the state n, so it is mean rate out. So from this we can conclude that the rate at which the system enters a particular state is equal to the rate at which the system leaves the state. So rate in equal to rate out. This is called balance equation for this continuous time Markov chain. So using this expression, we can derive for all states, like for state 0, state 1, state 2, state 3, and so on, for n states, we can derive the expressions for probability that the system is in a particular state. So here, P0 is the probability that the system is in state 0, P1 is the probability that the system is in state 1, P2 for state 2, P3 for state 3, and so on, Pn for state n. So we can derive expressions for all these probabilities, and as sum of probabilities equal to 1, using that we can find out the expected number of customers in the queuing system at any time t, and expected number of customers in the queue. Similarly, the average time spent by a customer in the system as a whole, and the average waiting time of a customer in the queue. So all these expressions can be derived using this balance equation for this birth and death process. Thank you very much. In some other video, I will explain how this balance equation, that is rate in equal to rate out, can be used to derive the probabilities P0 to Pn for different states, as well as to find the expected number of customers in the queue and system, as well as average waiting time of a customer in the queuing system as well as in the queue. Thank you very much.